Hey, welcome in. Thanks for stopping by. As always, we welcome you to Everything Money. I'm your host, Seth. I'm here with Paul, my dear friend and lover. We're not really lovers, Paul. We say that. I joke around.
We're not really lovers.
Are you guys married? But thank you for stopping in. In this video, we're going to talk about profit growth. It's one of our eight pillars we use to analyze a company, the fundamentals of a company, whether we're going to buy or sell or avoid a stock. And profit growth seems pretty intuitive, Paul. Like, are they making money? But there's lots of ins and outs about whether how the company is making money, how does this relate to their revenue. We did a video on revenue growth, and this certainly relates. So Paul's going to go into why profit growth is important, what you should be looking at, and what metrics you should use to determine if you're interested in a company. So go ahead, Paul. Tell me about it.
So a quick high level. Company needs profit in order to sustain itself. There's only so long you can operate without profit. There are plenty of companies out there that have lost money for years and years and years. Amazon took well over a decade. I think it was probably almost 15 or 16 years before it was actually able to make a profit consistently. So a lot of companies will do that. But the companies we're trying to look at are more stable companies. And we want to look at them and say, how is their profit relative to their revenue? Is their profit growing? Is it declining? Because if you remember in our first video about price to earnings ratio, the earnings part, that's profit. Profit's called earnings and net income. It's all the same thing, okay? It's after taxes, and it's what the company is left with at the end of the day after paying all of their expenses. If you see a company growing in profit, that is better than a company declining in profit. That doesn't mean that a company declining in profit is not worth anything. You have to factor that decline into the equation when you determine the value of the company. So let me give this example I always like to give. Company A and Company B. Let's say they're the exact same company, exact same industry, everything's the same except for this. The profit for Company A is $1 the first year. It's going to be $2, $3, $4. Okay? Company B is 4, 3, 2, 1. Over these 4 years, they each make the exact same amount of money. But this one's increasing and this one is decreasing. Which one would you pay more for, Seth?
Increasing growth.
Of course. Now, with that said, does that mean this one's worth nothing? This is going to generate $10 in profit over the next 4 years. Even if it goes to zero, isn't that worth something?
It is.
Great.
So you've taught me it is. I would normally think it's not, but
really, you would have thought it's not.
It's worth a dying company. I'm just going to avoid it.
But so if I could tell you right now, I'd give you $10 in the next 4 years, you wouldn't pay me $2 for that?
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Now you know that. And I want our viewers and our patrons to all understand this, that profit declining doesn't mean the company is worth nothing. It just means to pay less for the company because eventually it'll probably go to zero or start losing money, correct? So in this situation with profit, what tends to happen in the markets, however, is people tend to give too much value and pay too much for growing profit. The one thing I always hear in our videos is, Paul, you don't get it. The profit's growing like crazy. This is a growing company. Great. So let me ask you this question. Go back to that example. Let's say a company was going to increase like this by a dollar for the next four. This is $10 in profit. Let's say the world ends right here. The world ends right there. $10 in profit. Are you willing to pay $10 for it?
Not really.
Why would you pay $10 today for $10 4 years from now?
Yeah,
over the next 4 years. Of course not. Would you pay $9 for it?
Yeah, this is where it gets tricky, huh?
Would you pay $8? Would you pay $7? Would you pay $6? There is some number all the way down to $1 or zero that you want to pay for the stream of income, right? There's a point where you're paying too much, and there's a point where you're getting the screaming deal. Somewhere in the middle is a reasonable number. How much? I don't know. But this is what you have to do when you look at the net income of a company. If you see it growing, you have to sit there and do some analysis of what is that growth worth to me, because any investment is the present value of all future cash flow. And for the time being, in net income and cash flow will equate each other out over long periods of time. So over here, you have to just decide to yourself, what am I willing to pay to have that growth? The great thing about companies that are increasing their net income every year is they're providing a lot of benefit of saying, hey, invest in us and we're gonna build upon our own cash, we're gonna build upon our own earnings, and we're gonna keep becoming a better and better company. And if you remember, in the PE ratio, price divided by earnings, if it's always 15, as earnings go up, so will price. If you're always wanting to pay 15 times a company's earnings for the company, when the earnings goes up, then the price will go up. And that's how people make money on their stock going up in price. Earnings go up, price goes up. It's very simple. Net income, I don't like to look at net income on a year-to-year basis because any year can be affected by a million things that are one time. I like to look at five-year runs of net income, just like revenue. And the reason being is I want to see how does the company do over longer periods of time. I will even look back 10 years. Doesn't mean that the past is going to be the replication of the future, but it'll tell me how did this company operate over the last 5 or 10 years. Are the same people in charge? What is their plan for the future to make the next 10 years look as close to the last 10 years as possible? Does that make sense, Seth?
Yeah. Do you like to pull up a couple of companies so we can look at
them? I'd love to.
So in our last video on revenue growth, we talked about the importance of revenue and how it transfers into valuing a company. We looked at Microsoft, which has been steadily increasing their revenue and profit over the past 10 years. And the opposite of which is BlackBerry, which is someone might think is a dying company. So Paul's going to pull up both and we'll compare them right now.
This is Microsoft, guys. This is our Everything Money website, which you can get by being a patron. It tells you all the eight pillars. It's a wonderful website. I make it very simple for everybody on the main page. You pull up a company like Microsoft, it's going to tell you its last 12 months of profit right here. 12 months of net income, $51.3 billion. That in and of itself doesn't tell me enough, but it just tells me, boy, this company makes a lot of money, right? Okay, so then what I do is I go to the income statement and I sort the income statement in this drop down by four quarters at a time. And I scroll here to the bottom of the income statement. I look at net income, because remember, net income equals profit equals earnings. They're the same thing. They're always interchangeably used. Now look at this. Let's look at the last 10 years. 23.5, 15.5, 22.8, 20.7, 11.7, 22.6, 13.8, 33.5, 44, 51. There are ups and downs, but what do we see here trending? It's going up consistently. And I'm going to bet in big years of big drops, there were some sort of write-offs. Whenever you see a big drop from a year-to-year basis, there's probably some sort of write-off that happened that caused the company to say, you know what? We made this investment. It kind of sucked. We got to write off the investment. Great. Good for you. Just make sure it's not a consistent thing. This happened 3 times for Microsoft in the last 10 years. And I didn't even look to see if this actually would happen. I know this did happen. This was Motorola, I believe. I don't know the other two. But you see a company here that's doing a great job of increasing their revenue and therefore leading to the bottom line profit being higher and higher and higher. Remember, guys, this is after tax. They paid $9.5 billion in tax and still were left with $51 billion in profit. So this is a company that's profits going up, the revenue's going up, a lot of big pluses. And if you've seen Microsoft stock over the last 10 years, where has it gone?
Yeah.
To the moon.
Yeah.
Because of things like this, okay? Now, let's look up a beautiful company like BlackBerry. BlackBerry is, I love BlackBerry as a, I used to love my BlackBerry phone, but as you can see from the net income, it's been a tough go for BlackBerry in the last 10 years. They made $1 billion to start the last 10 years ago, right? Since then, lost 650, lost 5.9 billion, lost 300, lost 200, lost $1.2 billion, made 400, made 100 million, lost 150, lost $1.1 billion. They keep losing money hand over fist. Now, does this mean BlackBerry is not a good investment? I don't know, but I will say, I don't like this consistent loss. Unless I really believe that BlackBerry had a plan going forward to turn this thing around and that we're all missing something, I do not like this. This tells me like there's only a few years of profit in the last 10 years. Only a few years of profit. This is not enough for me to get excited. They went from making $1 billion to losing $1 billion all in a 10-year period. So again, you don't dismiss anybody just because they're making less money. But you also look at it and say, okay, there's serious problems at BlackBerry. What's the reason before I invest that maybe we turn around? Maybe you read something in their annual report last year that said, here's another area of the business, of the world we're going into. And because of this, this, and this, we expect to have revenue and profit increase. Oh, okay, maybe this works. Nobody else is reading the 10K because nobody cares about BlackBerry. But these are two companies that ironically, 15 years ago, 12 years ago, one was considered dead, Microsoft, and one was considered the dominant one. And since then, they flipped roles, right? Mm-hmm. Now Microsoft's the dominant one and BlackBerry is considered dead. So these are the things to look at. Again, no one pillar tells us if we should buy or sell, but all together, all the pillars together will give us an idea of what questions to ask and how to look forward in the future about what kind of expectations we can have about the company.
That is our take on profit growth. If this style of investing, looking at the math, kind of a nerdy way of looking at companies, resonates with you, join us and all the bidding ass nerds in our Patreon. The link is in the description below. We can guide you through this. A lot of folks have never heard of or ever been a part of a Patreon group, and you can be a part of our community. If you feel alone out there and you're investing and want to join us, you can talk to like-minded people on a daily basis in our Discord. You get access to Paul, I, and our trader Mo, and it's incredible. So we'll keep coming with these beautiful videos, and we appreciate your support out there. That is our take on profit growth and why it's important for the fundamentals of a company. Tickle that thumbs up on the way out. You know I love you. See you guys.